Now, this is the fly I'm going to be tying. It's basically just a river wet fly, or spider pattern. Now, it's quite a simple fly to tie. This is a hare's ear and woodcock, meaning the woodcock hackle and the hare's ear body with a gold rib. Now, it's a simple fly, as I say, to tie. The size I'm going to be tying is a 14. Now, the hook choice is entirely up to yourself. This is a fully mill. It's an all-purpose medium size 14. Now, the thread I'm going to be using is a uni thread in yellow. Now, I'll run the wax through it. I'm just start at the eye. Just going to put down a layer of thread and then remove the waste as I go to get in line with the point of the hook. Then we tie in a small gold tinsel. Now, the easiest tinsel to find would be the Lagerton. Now, what I'm going to do here is tie this on about a tag length, which is about maybe 2 to 3 turns, and then tie it on with touching turns of the thread up to that point there. Now, the body, you could use a natural hare's ear, or in this case, I'm going to use a dyed yellow. Now, the fur itself, it's quite easy. Just tear it away from the ears. I just tear it off until I get enough for the dubbin, for the body. When you tear it off, it actually mixes it up as well. So, we'll just lightly dub it onto the thread. Now, you want some of the guard hairs to sort of spring away from the body, so just work our way up. And some sort of slight taper in the body. To get to this point here. Now, there's fibres going forward of the eye. Just draw them back with your fingers. Just take your time, do a turn, and this will lock them back. What I'm doing here is just slightly open the fibres out so that I can bring the tinsel up through. Now, you're looking, as I say, 2 to 3 turns at the back, and then wind our tinsel up through around about, in this case on this side, around about 3 to 4 turns. Oops. Just pulling back the ribbons, I was pulling back the fibres there, so just be careful, keep it tight. Come up with the thread, take it to the eye, then come back up. Keeping the hold of the thread tight, they can bend and break away the tinsel. Gives you a neater cut if you do that. Now, I want some more of the dubbin coming out, so I'm just going to use the Velcro. Now, take the thread out of the way, you don't want to touch the thread with the Velcro. The first thing we do is a bit of wax on the thread, and then we're going to use one of the Covert feathers on the woodcock, this one here. This is the wing, and the Covert feathers are actually at the elbow part. Now, depending on the size of the fly, but what I'm looking for is a nice, well marked feather. Just see how you look, that's fine, you can see there. Now, what I'm going to do here is draw back what I don't need. Now, if you hold the stem, especially to this point where the head of the fly is, this will give you the length of the fibre you're going to get towards the back. You can have it short or as long as you like. I find it works both ways. So take away what you don't need. You know, a small pair of hackle pliers here, and when you get hold of the tip, draw back the fibres to reveal the tip of the feather. Trim away, trim it to about a mil away from the point where you're going to tie it, where you're going to tie it on. Make sure you're waxing on your thread. Take it to the height, and then what I'm going to do, draw back the fibres, do one turn in front of the other. So you just take your time, nice straight turns. As long as you're heading towards the eye, we come up that last turn, catch it with the thread. Now, the stems of these feathers are very fine, so we can actually fold them back. Take the thread up and form a nice head. You can break that off. Straight in and quick finish, always keeping the thread nice and tight. And there we are. Now, tighten up. Now, the thread's waxed, so you really don't need to varnish the head if you don't need to, because the wax will give it plenty of grip. Just going to take the excess wax away. So, I hope you enjoyed that fly, and I'm sure if you tie a few up, between 12s and 16s is three good sizes,